Bloody, battered and bruised, but still alive. Anti-government protester Dmytro Bulatov was kidnapped and tortured for a week before being dumped in a forest. He's recovering in a private hospital here, but he's covered in cuts and bruises. I had my hands pierced. They've crucified me, he says. They've cut off my ear, cut my face. All my body is beaten, black and blue. The police are investigating, but the protesters believe the security forces are behind this and at least two other abductions. Many more are being held by the police after the two sides clashed last week. The international community is calling for restraint, as well as an investigation into the claims of kidnap and torture.
We're appalled by the deaths reported in recent days in Kiev, which should be promptly, thoroughly and independently investigated. We're also calling for an investigation into reports of kidnappings and torture.
Despite the freezing cold temperatures, thousands of protesters remain in their camps, holding the Maidan or Freedom Square in central Kiev. Negotiations are taking place to find a way forward, but these people want the president to stand down. He won't, though.
Although he's apparently ill, President Yanukovych has agreed the repeal of anti-protest legislation. He's also signed into law an amnesty for protesters who are being held by the police. But it's dependent upon these protest groups leaving buildings that they currently hold. And they say they're not going to do that. So we're back at a sort of impasse. More worryingly for these people is that the military have now written to the president saying that he needs to solve this situation. They don't know whether they're softening their position or whether they're wanting to come into this camp and smash it up.
If that happens, the protest groups have promised to fight back, guaranteeing more bloodshed. The two sides are at loggerheads. So far, there seems little chance of any negotiated end to this anytime soon. Stuart Ramsey, Sky News, Kiev.